Hi. This paper, Methodology for the Development of the Allergic Rhinitis and Its Impact on Asthma, Guidelines from Evidence to Decision Frameworks to Digitalized Shared Decision-Making Algorithms, presents the methodology for the ARIA-EAACI 2024-2025 guidelines. This is an update of the ARIA guidelines, a project founded by Professor Jean Bousquet in 2001, and which has ever since been iteratively updated. And it's important to discuss the methodology, as these guidelines are meant to be patient-centered, digitally enabled with information from direct patient data and AI-assisted. In a nutshell, in terms of the methodology, we gathered a guideline panel consisting of 30 experts of different fields, including patients, and this panel proposed some questions. In addition, we gathered questions from what patients were searching on the web and questions suggested by AI. We ended up with 39 prioritized questions, which we addressed in terms of nasal symptoms, ocular symptoms, quality of life, serious adverse events, and any adverse events. And for each of these questions on the pharmacological treatment of allergic rhinitis, we gathered evidence through the evidence to decision framework, which led to a recommendation. And here we used several sources, in particular, in terms of the desirable and the undesirable effects of the interventions, that is, the benefits and harms of the medication. We conducted several systematic reviews of randomized controlled trials. We also looked at pharmacovigilance data in order to understand the adverse events of treatments for rhinitis. For values and preferences, we conducted a systematic review and we have analyzed mascare data. Then, in terms of costs and cost effectiveness, we conducted a survey to ARIA experts and we looked at data from the mobile health app Mascare. And to evaluate the equity of allergic rhinitis interventions, we consulted the WHO list of essential medicines, while for acceptability, we looked on Mascare data on aspects such as treatment satisfaction, use of co-medication, and adherence. Finally, there was another criteria that we considered in order to make our recommendations, which was the impact of interventions on planetary health. Thank you.